Hey everyone, welcome to this week's Wednesday One Thing. My name is Hamza, I'll be your host today, and I'm joined with my colleagues, Maury and Vasiliki. How's it going, guys?
Doing well, man. Killing it as always. Vas, what's up with you?
Doing well as well. Exciting updates from the Black Friday, Cyber Monday weekend, so very pumped.
Yeah, absolutely. So needless to say, this week's theme is the obvious, which was the centerpiece of the e-commerce year, Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and the impact that weekend has had on all our lives. So 2020's Black Friday was expected to be the biggest weekend of online shopping in history as consumers looked online due to the novel coronavirus pandemic. And online merchants had urged consumers to shop small and local due to the impact, of course, of lockdowns on small businesses. And it appears consumers listened. So Clearbanc's data suggests that this year, online businesses with revenues under $50,000 per month saw a 106% increase in sales compared to 2019 over the same weekend. And for businesses between $50,000 to $300,000, it was a 56% increase to BFCM in 2019. Now, for Black Friday specifically, Adobe, which is following online sales in real time at 80 of the top 100 retailers in the US, said US consumers spent $9 billion online on Friday, up from 21% on a year ago. And figures from Shopify, which analyzes activity from all of its merchants, you know, on its e-commerce platform, about more than a million, said that the peak shopping hour on its platform was 9 a.m. Eastern on Friday, where there were as many as $3 million in sales per minute. As for Cyber Monday, it was projected to be the largest online shopping day in US history, and it did deliver just that, a 15% increase over last year, coming in at a whopping $10.8 billion for the day. It continued to dominate the holiday shopping season despite early discounts from retailers. So Vas, I want to open up the discussion a little bit and get your opinion on what do you think were some of the changes that drove online sales to the extent that they did? What was so different about, apart from the obvious and the pandemic, what else was so different about the way consumers shopped this year?
Yeah, I think there's two main factors that really contribute to the success of online e-commerce in the Black Friday, Cyber Monday space. The first is really just consumers just being much more conscious with where their dollars are going. A lot of what we understand from a pandemic perspective, local businesses are being the ones hit the most, and customers and citizens of society, to put it at least, are very conscious of how they want to be directing their dollars to impact the communities around them. And that's where we saw a huge increase in small businesses and how they were able to hit revenue highs. The second piece is also just the shift towards mobile e-commerce. It's very easy for us to understand that, like, we're spending so much time on our phones. The shift towards mobile shopping has dramatically increased amongst this pandemic. And it was only even further evident during Black Friday that ease and that comfort of transitioning to that kind of consumer shift was really prevalent in the sales and how it really impacted this entire season. So I think those two main pieces is what really contributed to the success of this year.
Yeah, absolutely agree and resonate on that. And the mobile shopping part is a very, very interesting point, because mobile sales as a percentage were pretty much stable on Shopify and on Amazon and a lot of other online merchants over the weekend. But it is an interesting trend in the sense that so many more consumers are shopping through mobiles. The Shopify shop app was, I think, one of the highest on the App Store over the weekend. And clearly that accessibility is changing the way consumers buy their products. One interesting point that a lot of analysts brought up was, although this was the record-breaking weekend that people had predicted, the numbers weren't quite up there for the single weekend expenditure that a lot of analysts were forecasting. Maury, I want to open this up to you a little bit. Why do you think, what factors do you think drove Black Friday to, well, obviously, you know, while being record-breaking, not quite what analysts had pointed out to?
For me, the numbers are pretty startling, like regardless of how you slice it. So people were expecting it to be a huge Black Friday, huge Cyber Monday, which it was, perhaps the reason they weren't seeing this giant, huge spike is just because the holiday season is no longer just Black Friday. People have been shopping for the holidays since the beginning of November. People have been transitioning a lot of their shopping online since March, since when this happened. So usually when, I think actually Shopify even put up this really great chart where it shows last year, you have this big spike in purchases on Black Friday, Cyber Monday. Now you just think it's all been distributed throughout the year. So we're having record-breaking months, months after month after month. And I think this is a really good indicator for businesses to start now who maybe didn't get on the online trend to push their businesses online. But all this online shopping is going to keep going throughout the year and beyond. So perhaps, you know, all these companies are sort of creating their own shopping holidays. So Amazon has a Prime Day that happens in July, or, you know, there's Singles Day in November. There's going to be way more shopping opportunities throughout the entire year.
Yeah, great points, Maury. And a great segue to some other numbers. You know how much I love numbers. So just to throw up some percentages, there was a 24% decline in sales in brick and mortar retailers this year. There was a 30% growth of curbside pickups year over year on Cyber Monday. And it was a 37%, the portion of total Cyber Monday sales for mobile devices was up to 37% this past Monday. So not only do we have a record-breaking Friday and a record-breaking Monday, we're also expecting a record-breaking Tuesday. I say this because the data on Tuesday isn't super clear yet, but what's known as Giving Tuesday is expected to touch around $4.1 billion in sales. Sort of an afterthought almost at this point, given the numbers that Black Friday and Cyber Monday put up. And great points there as well, Maury, about the significance of upcoming shopping holidays like Singles Day. Vasa, to take it back to you, what are some of the major learnings that founders should keep in mind going into Black Friday, Cyber Monday 2021? Like, what is it that we should see in e-commerce in the next, let's say, 12 months from now?
Yeah, I think a big learning lesson from this year that was kind of forced upon from the pandemic, where the shopping season started much earlier than anticipated, is to really plan ahead the Black Friday. We saw a lot of brands actually adopt Black Friday weeks. And even beforehand, they had Black Friday sales like many times in advance of that, because a lot of the times these brands, they actually want to get ahead of the curve, especially when you consider that shipping providers are at their peak. They don't want customers to be upset. And so I've seen companies actually communicate them in their emails where they actually tell their customers, take the deals now. We're not going to have a Black Friday sale. We're going to have an early Black Friday sale so that you can actually leverage the fact that from an empathetic way, an authentic way, that our supply chains are going to be tight. We want to be conscious of the workers that we have employed, that they can still enjoy the holidays with their families, and you can get your products even earlier than anyone else. So I think that was actually a really authentic way to actually approach this entire season, and where the holiday season is actually spread out even further, and where you can make your Black Friday really any day you want. It's really up to you to make it. And that's something that I think is very creative that any brand can really adopt coming to the 2021.
Amazing. And Maury, just to bring it back to you a little bit as well. Now, ads, super important. Super, you know, necessary way of driving customer acquisition. What lessons can founders take away when it comes to online customer acquisition? I mean, this is something we've been speaking about for a few weeks now here on the Wednesday One Thing, about the different ways marketing and branding has been done by direct to consumer and online brands. What's been a big change this year?
I would just say diversify. Like, we saw year month over month and year over year change towards Google ads and less reliance on Facebook ads. So I would say diversify now, start getting on TikTok. I'm telling you, that's the hottest channel for organic traffic, and really diversify where you're spending money and where you're getting your audience from. Obviously, organic is always going to be the best way to have costless acquisition. But again, think about diversifying your ad strategy.
Amazing. Well, thanks as much as ever. Before we wrap up, quick quiz that I'd love to run again with some numbers. Vas, what do you think, which vertical, apart from the three biggest buckets of apparel, wellness, and home goods, saw the biggest increase in online revenue in the year 2020? I'll give you a hint. It was 250% year-over-year growth for this vertical.
I'll take a guess that it had something to do with tech, because tech is still very popping around the holiday season, more higher average order values I kind of proceed through.
Okay, not quite. It was medical supplies. Because of the impact of the pandemic, surprise, surprise, medical supplies saw a 250% increase. What do you think was another vertical that grew up by 105% this year after growing close to about 10% year over year in previous years? I'll give you a hint. It's not tech. It's not medical supplies, and it's something very, very different.
The next assumption that I'll go off of is pet supplies. Naturally, the pet industry does not decline in pandemic situations. They're like another child to any other family member. So maybe that's my second assumption.
So great guess. Pet supplies went up 56% this year, but the 106% increase actually goes to cannabis products. Typically not an industry that sees such rapid rise year over year, but looks like 2020 is a very different year compared to others. Well, that's it for our time today, guys. Maury, Vas, thanks so much as ever for taking out the time. Pleasure speaking with both of you, and looking forward to next week's Wednesday One Thing. Cheers, everyone.